In this video, you will learn how to get started with LoopToGO. There is two important steps to complete before starting to loop: choosing an audio interface and scanning the VST3 plugins. In this video, we will see how to do both. Note that these steps only need to be done once. We will also learn how to do our first simple loop. When you launch LoopToGO for the first time, it will ask if you want to scan for new VST3 plugins. We suggest that you click Yes to do the scan. The scanning will be done for the default directory. If you have plugins in other directories, you can go to Files, Preferences, Plugins, and add these directories to the list. Then you have to click on Scan New Plugins Only or Scan Plugins. LoopToGO works with VST3 64-bit plugins only. If you have older plugins, such as VST2 or 32-bit plugins, you can still use them in LoopToGO by using a plugin wrapper. See our fact page on our website for more details. If you don't have any plugins, you can still use LoopToGO, but you won't be able to add any audio effects, such as reverb or delay. You won't be able to have any virtual instruments either. If you are new to the plugin world, you have to know that there is plenty of great plugins, free or paid, available on the internet. Make sure you search for VST3 plugins. Before doing anything in LoopToGO, you will have to select an ASIO audio interface. ASIO is a protocol for low latency, high fidelity interface between a software application and a computer's sound card. To select the ASIO driver that will be used in LoopToGO, select Files, Preferences, Audio. Then, select your audio interface ASIO driver. In the right part of the dialog, you will see the current configuration of this driver, such as the buffer length and the sample rate. We strongly recommend that you use name mapping for the audio inputs and outputs. It is a good practice and will allow you to use different hardware configurations without having to modify your projects. To do so, simply click on the mapped name under the mapping column. You are now ready to do some music. For the next example, let's say you have a mic and a guitar connected to your audio interface, and that you have mapped the inputs and outputs accordingly. First, you have to add at least one effect chain. Let's add a guitar chain. Simply right-click on the chain editor view and select Add New Chain. Then, click on Select Audio and MIDI I/O, check the guitar input and left and right outputs. Click OK. You can see that the Select Audio and MIDI I/O button has turned from red to black. It means that it has been configured. Now, when we play the guitar, the sound is sent back to the audio interface and we can see the meters moving. Now, let's add some effects. At the top right of the screen, type VERB in the filter field. It will show all the plugins that includes verb in their name or category or in their vendor's name. To add a plugin to our first chain, we simply drag and drop the plugin. To configure the plugin, click on the plugin's name. Now let's do our first loop. Click on the looper tab. Say we want a loop that is 2-bar long and repeats for 4 bars. Select the record mode by pressing on the red arrow button and draw a 2-bar rectangle. Then, select the play mode by pressing on the green arrow button and draw a 4-bar rectangle. To make sure we play on beat, let's configure the metronome by clicking on the metronome button. We will set 4 ticks before the recording starts and 8 ticks, or 2 bars, while recording. We will also use a tempo of 70 BPM and select the left and right audio outputs. Let's try that. That's all for this video. Make sure you check our website or the other video for more advanced tips. Thank you for watching.